Hey class, this is Ms. Hawk, and today I'm going to walk you through how to download fonts from the internet to your Chromebook, laptop, home computer, whatever you're using. This tutorial is done on my Mac laptop, but it'll be the exact same process for Windows. There shouldn't be any huge differences, so either way, you'll be able to follow along. So you're probably asking, Ms. Hawk, why is it important that we change our fonts? Can't we use Times New Roman the entire time? And the answer is that it depends on what you're creating. It depends on the style of your thing that you're creating. So this is an infographic that's really helpful. It tells you what kind of style you're going for and then what kind of fonts you should be using. So if you want a really traditional or a formal style, these are the fonts you're using. So you can use Times, Georgia, any of those. If you're creating like a really fancy invitation, then you're gonna want something that's elegant or classic. So these fonts will do as well. And it's not just limited to these fonts. You can use any type of script font. So the type of font that you choose can help relay your style to your audience. It can also help convey some type of an emotion, something you want your audience to feel. So this table lists a bunch of different emotions and the fonts that are best to convey those emotions to your audience. And I'll post links for both of these resources in the description box. I thought this one was really comprehensive, so there's a lot of different emotions and different fonts that you can use. So in order to find your fonts, you want to make sure that they are free for use, so you're not going to get copyright dinged or have to worry about that. So the sites that I use are defont.com, or you can use Font Squirrel. And before you download any fonts, it's really important that whatever resource you're going to be using these fonts with is completely sh shut down. You've quit, you're out of it. So Word, LibreOffice, PowerPoint, anything like that, you need to make sure it's not currently open or the fonts aren't going to download properly. So to download a font to your computer, you're going to pick whichever one you want first. I'm going to use Moontails because it's kind of fun, and I want to add that to a PowerPoint and see what kind of style it adds to that. So I'm going to click Download, and you'll get this box that pops up. You want it to be whatever the default is because it's going to lead you straight to your font folder. So you'll click OK. And then you'll get your downloads menu that pops up. You want to double click on your font folder. And then you want to click on the title of your font. So mine is Moontails. So I'm going to click Moontails Demo. And you'll double click that. And then it'll give you this preview of what it's going to look like when you type out. And if you look at the bottom right-hand corner, it'll say Install Font. And you're going to want to click that. And then hopefully, if all has been said and done the right way, your font folder will appear and the font will be added to that folder. So to make sure the font actually downloaded, you're now going to open whatever type of Word document, PowerPoint presentation, whatever you want to use it for. So I'm going to open LibreOffice. I'm going to click the PowerPoint that I've already started. And I want to make sure Moontails downloaded, and I just want to change the font on this to make it look a little more fun since this presentation is for you guys. So I'm going to highlight my text that I've already typed. I'm going to right click, and then I'm on my menu, I'm going to click character. You don't want to click text, you want character. And then your font box will appear, and you're going to type in the name of your font, so Moontails, and then you'll click OK. And then hopefully, if everything went well and there weren't any bugs within the font code, your font will have been changed. So I think this adds a little bit of fun to my slide. I want it to be a little more friendly and fun because this is aimed for teens for you guys, so I want a font that shows that as well. So if you have any other questions, please let me know. We can troubleshoot and figure out if fonts aren't working for you. There are a lot of other different font sites as well. So I hope this helped, and I hope you have fun choosing your fonts.